brought me through to this moment, and I am so grateful and so thankful. So everybody, let's give God a praise this morning. God is here. God is here. Praise our Lord for this Mother's Day again. And all of us who have our mothers here, we are grateful and thankful. And all of us have our memories of our mothers who have gone on. So, right now, are there any May birthdays here today? Anybody has a birthday?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Selma Ince. I'm coming up on the right side of the mountain to know that he will welcome me there. He understands. He'll say, well done. Laura W. Day, I am so grateful that Christ is in my life. Thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:57. Kathleen Lopey, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Donna McLean, in the sweet by and by, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Doreen Vera Lopey, Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Marlene Adams Patterson, Margaret Gordon, 101 years. St. John 14, 1-6. We'll understand it better by and by. May Shepherd, 100 years. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about my troubles. Beverly Powell, Psalm 103, praise the Lord. Teach me, Lord, how to wait. Esther Johnston, Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Ethel Johnston, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Edith Cunningham, Jesus loves the little children. Daisy Drummond, his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Thelma Marsman, the beauty of his garden may not be understood, but we know that God created it for our eternal good. Cora Howe, bless the Lord, O my soul. I sing because I'm happy. Irma Farmer, Dale Farmer, Marlene Farmer, all three sisters. Phyllis Clayton, his eye is on the sparrow. Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Jehalia Smith, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. This is my story, this is my song. Geraldine Parker, if I can help somebody as I pass along, his eye is on the sparrow. Exodus 27, you shall not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Madeline Beals, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Pastor Iona Crawley, near the cross, Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord and lean not unto thine own understanding. Gloria Adams, blessed assurance. Alvina Kane, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Psalm 32:11, rejoice in the Lord and be glad, you righteous, sing all you who are upright in heart. Shirley Mossman Lopi. Jesus loves me, this I know. Evelina Upshaw. I love the Lord, he heard my cry. Ada Upshaw. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Eileen Lucas, Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Della Jewel Adams, I surrender all. Psalm 121, I lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Lena Mae West, oh, that union band, we'll join that yes. union band.
Yes. Yes.
Elsie Bernard, I shall know him by the prints of the nails in his hands. Najina Bernard, my Redeemer lives. These are the names that were given thus far. If there are indeed names of your mom and she wasn't called this morning, please feel very confident in calling your mom's name and standing at this time.
Betty Jeffries, Mother Thomas,
Linda Thorne,
Sarah Cross,
Beatrice Clark,
Dorothy Andrews, Sandra Adams.
Let us pray just for a moment. Our Father in heaven, Lord God, we come this morning and these precious moments, these precious times right now, in this hour, this precious memories hour, Lord, when we just pause, Lord, just to remember her.
Yes.
Just to recall, Lord, what she said, what she did, how she said it, how she did. Thank you, Lord, that you gave us the greatest gift of all, your son. And then, Lord, you said, woman, behold thy son. Son, behold thy mother. That's the importance of mom. Father God, we just pray your continued blessings upon each one of us, Lord, this day. As we celebrate, Lord, this Mother's Day, and as we celebrate, Lord, our lives that we continue to just live the legacy that she gave, that she passed on to her children and grandchildren and greats. We pray your peace, your love, your support, and your fun and laughter throughout this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Thank you.
Scotia, Canada. She grew up in Kumala Street Baptist Church, now New Horizons Baptist Church. As a child, she started off a member of the children's choir led by the late great-grandmother, Sister Lena Mae West, former member, Seaview Baptist, Africville. Then established membership at Kumala Street Baptist up until she passed. Was baptized at early age at Cornwallis and was a member of several church organizations throughout the years, including the senior choir at age 12. God gave me a voice to sing of the goodness of God, love throughout my Christian journey. Great, thank you. Whether it has been in use at my home church of Kumala Street Baptist, singing, witnessing throughout Canada, the United States, or around the world, God continues to bless her voice to be shared in continuous witness of God's love, grace, and mercy. It is a privilege to sing at my church
in front of me this morning. And this Mother's Day can be a very emotional day for many, for myself, remembering those precious, precious memories and how they do linger and how they ever flood our soul. But today, I have a treat for you. And I know my Aunt Beatrice is not aware of this, but I'm giving honor and tribute to my grandmother, the late Sister Lena Mae West, and I'm going to be doing a duet with her today. I'm going to be doing a duet with her today, so just bear with me.
Mountains. They prayed, but the prayers were too. for my Aunt Mary, Aunt Doll, we called her. So I wear this in her memory, as she wore it many times before. Blessings.
Acknowledgements here to read. To New Horizons Baptist Church in memorial from Donna Goff, $200 gift. And also $20 gift from Donna Goff for Ollie B. Mack memories. In memory of Sister Beth Powell. And we also have $100 in memory of brothers and sisters who have passed from our church family, Brother Lester Powell, $100. And another, Sister Beverly Powell. Okay, those were the checks, yeah. Okay. And in loving memory of our mother, grandmother, Sister Shirley Lopi Mosman, and great-grandmother, from Sister Frieda Oliver and family, $50. In loving memory, God has blessed me with two beautiful mothers, Sister Shirley Lopi Mosman and Sister Esther Pearl Johnston. Miss you, your daughter Shirley Lopi. $100. In loving memory of our mother, grandmother, and great-grandmother, Sister Shirley Lopi Mosman from Sister Debbie Delmore and family.
Delorme.
Sorry. Delorme. I have heard that name before. $100. In memory of Sherna. No. I don't know that name. Sharna Lopi. Mother, grandmother, great grandmother, love you, family.
Alvina.
Okay. Okay. I couldn't make it out. No, I'm sorry. That's $200. Okay. Thank you all so much. These memories. Praise God. Precious memories. Okay, now we have Deacon Melinda to give the blessing.
Father in heaven, we come this morning thanking you, Lord, for your bountiful blessings upon each one of us. Lord, we recognize this morning and that we can do nothing of ourselves, but we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. We recognize this morning, Lord, that we can't be God-giving. No matter how we try, that Lord, you love us, you keep us, you sustain us, you guide us, protect us, you lead us, you strengthen us, and you provide. We ask you, Lord, your blessings upon this offering this morning. We pray, God, for those who are able to give at this time, and those who, for whatever reason, Lord, you know all about us, just not able to do so right now. We pray your blessings upon this offering, that it may be used for the building of your kingdom here on earth. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you.
mothers, even the dads that take on mother's role. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Oh, dear gracious Heavenly Father, we just thank you, God, for waking us up this morning and letting us see a brand new day and just giving us life, oh God. We just thank you and glorify your name, Father. You're worthy and grateful to be praised, oh God. I come thanking you, oh Father, for what you have done for New Horizons, Lord, that you gave us this brand new renovated church, oh Lord, that only you could do for us, oh Lord. And I just thank you and glorify your name for all the goodness that you have bestowed upon us, oh Lord. I come thanking you, oh God, for the new beginners who gave their life to the Lord since we have opened our doors again, oh God. And I thank you for the increase of the kingdom, oh God. And I ask you, God, just to give us the mercy and the grace and the love to bring them to a higher ground, oh God, and let them know that every day, no matter what struggles we go through, that you love us and that you're there. Yes. And for us who lost our, who no longer have our moms, but we do have memories, and we do have precious memories. Yes. And we just thank our mothers who are gone on the glory that they raised us to worship and glorify his name. And I thank you for that, Jesus. I just thank you for our pastor, actually you're both pastors, pastor, our senior pastor, Pastor Rhonda Britton, and our pastor, Grace Gear, oh God. I thank you for them. I thank you, Lord, for giving Pastor Britton a rest, oh God, a well-deserved rest. It wasn't an easy, it's not an easy task to take on a task to build a church or to renovate even your own home. It's always challenges, oh God, and I thank you that you gave her to us for this particular time. I thank you for Pastor Spears' ministry, oh God, with the families and young people, oh God. Just be all around her and about her, oh God. I pray for our young people, oh God. I ask for increase of our young people. And I just thank the ones who've been coming since they were little kids, oh God, and sitting at your feet, Jesus, and learning more and more about you. And again, I ask you, oh God, help us to guide them, lead them, and teach them, oh Father. You're a mighty, mighty God. You can do all things in Jesus Christ's name. Hallelujah, God. And I just glorify you and just thank you, oh God, for the things that you have done for us. Sometimes we forget when things are going good, that you always get you in there in the rough times and the struggles in our lives. And I thank you, Lord, for bringing us out of the mess that we were in and holding us accountable and calling on your name and believing in you. Father God, you said in your word that all we need is the faith of a mustard seed. And a mustard seed is very small. And I'm telling you this morning, church, if we believe that much, Jesus is with us and he loves us. And for any unbelievers that are here, just put your hand in Jesus. Let him guide you. You can't guide. You can't give up nothing on your own. It's only Jesus when he feels fit to show you how to do it. Just learn, stay in your word. God's word, his Bible, is for us for a purpose. And it's to lead us and guide us. And if we stay in his word, we'll grow and we'll love him more and more. I ask you, oh God, to anoint and be with our speaker as she brings the word of grace and mercy to us today, oh God. And I glorify your name. You're an awesome God, a God of worthy. You're worthy to be praised. We humble ourselves to you today, oh God, and just give you glory and mercy and honor. And for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that who should ever believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. In your holy and precious name, we say amen.
Amen. Scripture, I just want to say that, well, today is a joyful day where we honor our mothers and we honor the mothers among us. Let us all also remember that there are many mothers who suffer today. There are many mothers whose children cannot be with them. There are many mothers who stay awake at night worrying and worrying for their children. And so today for them is sometimes a day of deep suffering and pain. So let's hold them in our hearts. And first is 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 1 to 7. The wife of a man from the company of the prophets cried out to Elisha, "Your servant, my husband, is dead, and you know that he revered the Lord. But now his creditor is coming to take my two boys as his slaves." Elisha replied to her, "How can I help you? Tell me, what do you have in your house?" "Your servant has nothing there at all," she said, "except a little oil." And Elisha said, "Go around and ask all your neighbors for empty jars. Don't ask for just a few. Then go inside and shut the door behind you and your sons, and pour oil into all the jars. And as each is filled, put it to one side." And she left him, and afterward shut the door behind her and her sons. And they brought the jars to her, and she kept pouring. And when all the jars were full, she said to her son, "Bring me another one." But he replied, "There is not a jar left." And then the oil stopped flowing. And she went and told the man of God, and he said, "Go, sell the oil and pay your debts. You and your sons can live on what is left." The next passage is Psalm 139, verse 13 and 14. "For you created my innermost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. Praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well." And the last reading is from Psalm 31. 25:26. "She is clothed with strength and dignity. She can laugh all the days to come. She speaks with wisdom, and faithful instruction is on her tongue. Her children arise and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many women do noble things, but you surpass them all." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Good morning, church. What a great day it is to celebrate mothers and those who have taken on the role of mothers. Before I introduce our guest speaker, my daughter Cynthia, I want to tell you that when they asked me to introduce Cynthia, I said to myself, if they had asked Margaret Gordon, my mother, to introduce me, here's what she would have said. "You need to be careful what you ask people to do." because I'm going to give you the good, the bad, and the ugly. Now that's what she would have said. Anyway, it's my honor to introduce my daughter from another mother, Cynthia Jordan. She has the heart of a mother at the core. Not unlike most moms, we all have a tough job, and it's a job of sleepless nights sometimes. Hard decisions and sacrifice. Often it is thankless, and many times you go unrecognized. But the heart of a mom continues to love and care. And God has used the special love of a mom caring for her children. Cynthia is the mother of two boys born to her and the adoptive grandmother to her two girls, Maya and Chanel. She's a registered nurse by profession, so her heart is as big as her passion and love for Jesus. With big hearts come big hurts, and even bigger love, sacrifice, and grace from God. Thanks be to God. Cindy is not only blessed by all four of her children, she is also blessed to be getting ready to be married to a lovely man. Yes, indeed. From Ham's Plains, Cedric Williams. And all I ask, Cynthia, is that once you get married to Cedric, that you don't forget about me and Dad. So I'll end by saying I call it a privilege to have her call me mom.
I want to say thank you for the invite to speak. And I don't take this task lightly. As I don't take any task lightly. I learned that through the building project. But what I also learned is when God calls you, you don't say no. Because I said no initially to the building project. But I ended up doing it anyways because, you know, even the song says, when you say no or when others say no, and he says yes, he has his way. So even when we say no and he says yes, he still gets his way. But that's the type of God that we serve. Thank God he knows better than what we know. So typically in my journey with God, I have hung out in scriptures throughout my journey of faith. You know, I always go to the book of Genesis and, you know, see how things began. I find that very intriguing and interesting. And then go to the book of Revelations, see how things are going to end. That's typically what we all want, right? We want to know what's at the beginning, what's at the end. And what's in between, we kind of just scurry away from. But there's so much in between. So much in the Bible that God has told us, wants to teach us. And it's not until we dig deeper in the Word that we actually go and find out what it is that God wants us to do. What is it that he wants us to know? And today being Mother's Day and given this task, I did a little bit of research. And what I learned and where God took me was totally amazing. So God led me to 2 Kings 4, 1 to 7. The woman seeking wisdom. Seeking wisdom. And I said, God, what is it that you want me to learn? And a few things happened over the past few weeks that I won't bore you about, but I'll tell you that the Mother's Day message that God gave me is not one that was a warm and fuzziness. Because being a mother is not often warm and fuzzy. It's very challenging. It's a very challenging task. The only warm and fuzzy part of it is probably in the beginning. You got that cute little bundle of joy, right? And then they start to grow and they go through the, you know, terrible twos, and then they keep on growing and growing, and they get in the years of their adolescence, and like I did, right? And we start to make choices and decisions in our lives. And that leads to all different things, and which leads to, you know, how I ended up having the honor of being the daughter of Linda Nelson. I made many choices throughout my life. Some of them were my choices, and some of them weren't my choices. But God be the glory, he had a plan for me. Right? I have three mothers, and then some more. I always say to folks, you know,
God gave me many mothers because he knew I needed that guidance in my life. And I thank God for each and every one of them. I often say I have a mother that birthed me, that grew me, a mother that molded me, and one that grew me. You know, and I thank God for that at the various different times in my life that I needed it. And I'm veering off my script, but I'm just speaking from my heart. So when I dove into this scripture, just in 2 Kings, because when I went into the scripture, 2 Kings in those verses, I had to know, my curiosity led me to find out what was going on around this time, what was happening, you know, who was involved. So, you know, typically in the, you know, New Testimony, right, in the New Testament, rather, there's a lot of stuff and talk about, you know, Jesus and Jesus' journey. But this is the time before Jesus actually arrived, before Jesus was born in the Old Testament. And there was a lot of war and a lot of strife going on, battles, a lot of evil. Kind of feels like what's going on today in the world. And so I just kind of, you know, looked around a little bit more, and I still have more looking to do because I'm not a Bible scholar, and I'm guilty for not spending a whole lot of time in the scripture, not as much as I really should, because life happens, right? Busy mom, single mother for many years. I thank God he's changing that for me next month. Right? Thank God I'll have another guard to guard our house, right? Because we got two teenage girls coming up here. And there's going to be lots of challenges. But I just want to say that the scripture teaches us a whole lot about how to trust in God. And it wasn't the widow in this scripture that necessarily had to trust. It was Elijah who had an experience with Elijah, who God had taken up, right? In the previous chapters, if you go back, I encourage you to go to Word yourself and read the word and understand it, because God will have a message for you that might be different from the message he has for me. But he asked for the presence of the Holy Spirit. And with the presence of the Holy Spirit, Elijah spent a lot of time going around during a time of strife, war. And he was actually doing miracles. The whole book of 2 Kings is a list of a bunch of miracles that were happening. And that was before Jesus' time. So what we know about that is that God had been present. He's always been present. You know, God is everlasting. There's no beginning and no end. It didn't start when Jesus came. We tend to hang out in the New Testament because we want to know about Jesus. And we all want to know about Jesus, and we need Jesus, and we need to accept Jesus. But also, the message that God gave me here today is that we need to know about the Holy Spirit as well, and the power that the Holy Spirit has, and how the Holy Spirit can intercede on our behalf. So in this passage, the widow went to Elijah and asked Elijah for help. Ask for support, because the creditors were coming to take away their sons. And I automatically went back to thinking about days where our people were in slavery. And the masters would come and just take the children away. How does that leave a mother feeling? What does that do to a mother? You know, imagine, most of us here today are mothers in some kind of way, to have someone just ripped away and we never see them again. That's the ultimate pain of a mother. Nobody wants to imagine that pain. But that stuff is happening here today. It's happening in this city. And I believe with my heart that the Lord wants me to speak here today, and it's not me speaking. I'm just a vessel that God is using. But God, and I make no apologies, because I kind of, when I went to this word and I said, God, like, really, you want me to bring a message? Isn't Mother's Day supposed to be really, like, happy and cheerful and all that kind of stuff? Yeah, but God said, I want you to deliver this message. And the message is that we're in serious times. And the enemy is out there for our children. He's out there. He's snatching them up. He's taking them away. And we need to be, as mothers and grandmothers, aunties, mothers that haven't given birth to children, we need to be the intercessors. We need to be on watch. We need to ask for support when we don't have the resources. But God gives us everything we need, just as in this scripture. God gives us everything. Yes, the widow said to Elijah, please help me. He said, what do you have in your house? What do you have in your house? It's not going out and getting anything. God gives us everything we need. Everything. He is a provider. A provider. He gave us the word. His word is the weapon. It's the weapon against the enemy. The Holy Spirit. Knowing Jesus. We don't get to have the Holy Spirit unless we accept Jesus into our heart. So I'm here to tell you today that we're in a war for our children. And as mothers and grandmothers and fathers, as was just stated, right? We're all protectors. And God wants us to know that we are the intercessors. And that intercessors have a job to do. There's a role of the intercessors. I've learned that. And when he left, and what I learned when Eliza, there's two, and I'm like, okay, God, why are these names so similar and they sound the same in 2 Kings? I had to figure that out. But what I learned is that when Elijah was ascending to heaven, he didn't die, right? God took him up, right? Like, that's the amazing God that we have. But Elijah said to him, when you leave, can I have what you got? Can I have that what you have? Because Elijah seen Elijah, and I apologize if I don't say it right because they're so close, but he was breaking the sea with his cloak, parting the river Jordan with his cloak so that they could walk through, because he had the Holy Spirit with him, not on his own accord. We can't do anything on our own. We can't even walk without him holding our hand. So it's through God, knowing God, and accepting Jesus, and then asking for the presence of the Holy Spirit. And then that's when we become intercessors. And we look outside all the time. What are they going to do? What are the police going to do? What is this one going to do? What is that one going to do? But I'm here to tell you that God is saying, what are we going to do? He gives us. Depend on him. Depend on him. Equip yourself with the word and ask
for the presence of the Holy Ghost. And you, we will see change. We will see change. Let's start in our own household. I'll tell you that throughout this journey, the devil has been active. He didn't want you to hear this message today. I'll tell you why he didn't want you to hear the message. Because that's what he does. So this week there was all kinds of stuff going on in my household. All kinds of things. I'm not going to tell you all about it, but the devil was present. But so was God. God was there with me. Right? He's been there with me throughout my life. And he hasn't forsaken me. You know, I remember when Minister Thornton, when I first gave myself to the Lord, Minister Thornton said, "You didn't finish your testimony." And I told him, "No, I didn't." And I'm like, "You only get 3 minutes. My testimony's just way too big. I can't tell you everything. It's just too big." But what I'm telling you is that, and I'll leave you with this, the devil will show up in your house in so many ways. So many ways that he's a trickster, right? And we'll think that, well, it's okay because that's the way that the world is accepting and the way that the world wants us to go. But let me tell you something. Know your word and know what's of God. Because if something shows up in your house and it's not of God, then it's not God. That it is the devil. And I'll tell you something else. God has given us power and authority over the devil. So we don't need to fear him. We don't need to fear him. I actually heard something just recently, and how many people here, you know, you hear something at night and you're startled?
Yeah.
And you go down, you like, you creep down, it's like, "Oh my God, what's there, God?" Like, "Oh, I don't know what's there." And you know, you got your phone and you're kind of shaking, it's like, "Do I have to dial 911? You know, what's happening?" So this one man, he was in his bed and he heard this startling noise, and he got up and went down to the basement and, you know, went to the basement and turned on some lights, and guess what he seen? He seen the devil in his basement stirring around. So you know what he said? "Oh, it's only you." Turned off the light and said goodnight.
Judy Burton was born in Amherst, Nova Scotia. She arrived in Halifax in 1965 and has been a resident of the area ever since. Judy retired from the Department of Justice in 2003 as a court reporter and judicial assistant with the Supreme Court of Nova Scotia Family Division. Judy is a devoted wife, mother, and grandmother. She has remained a member of Highland AME Church in Amherst and has continued to be a regular adherent of this church for many years. Judy has traveled extensively with her husband Brad throughout Canada, the United States, the Caribbean, Bermuda, Africa, and abroad. Outside interests include the Recycled Teenagers of the Red Hatters Association, Dartmouth Christian Women's Association, and Fitness Fund for Seniors programs. Personal interests include gardening, word puzzles, trivia, home decor, and shopping. Preferred television viewings are classic movies, westerns, and reruns of Murder, She Wrote, and Columbia. I have known Judy for many years, and I am honored to introduce her.
I know that many of you this morning are as surprised as I am to see me standing behind the pulpit rather than being seated in the congregation. I never imagined I would be in this position either. I was contacted back in January by Sister Lana about speaking here today at this Mother's Day service. And when I gave her all the reasons as to why public speaking is not something I do easily or comfortably, especially in this venue, she was not ready to take no for an answer at that time. And furthermore, I added, what could I possibly have to say that anyone would be interested in hearing? She gave me a week to think and pray about it, which I did.
And with encouragement from my family and friends, I now stand before you. So please bear with me, as I am definitely out of my comfort zone, as this is not easy for me. But hopefully with God's strength, I will be able to successfully proceed with this assignment. I promise to be very brief and will not take up too much of your time. Let me first begin with a couple of scriptures. The first one is from John 16th chapter, verse 21. When a woman gives birth, she has pain because her time has come. But when the child is born, she no longer remembers her distress because of her joy that a child has been born into the world. And the second scripture is from Psalm 127, verse number 3. Behold, children are a gift from the Lord. The fruit of the womb is a divine reward. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his holy word. I grew up in Amherst in a loving, closely knit family of nine. Two parents, a sister, an aunt, two cousins, and grandparents. My father was a ship steward and was away for most months of the year. My grandfather was a double amputee and confined to a wheelchair. Needless to say, the three women, my mother Ruth, my aunt Dorothy, and my grandmother Elsie, ruled the household. I was fortunate to be under the positive influence of these fearlessly independent mothers, each contributing to our well-being in their own distinct ways. These women possessed strength and fortitude, both inner and physical, determination, and an abundance of wisdom which they themselves had gained over time. We were very fortunate to be on the receiving end of these attributes. Not only did they provide the necessities of life for us, but they also encouraged our personal growth and achievement in a positive, nurturing home environment. Knowledge is power, and so the importance of obtaining a good education to succeed in this world was also stressed by them. But more importantly, we grew up in a Christian home, with church attendance and involvement in church activities being a priority in our upbringing. My grandmother was a deaconess who made sure there was no slacking off when it came to church involvement. The church played an integral role in our lives, and we enjoyed every minute of being a part of it. These three mothers sowed the seeds of a strong religious foundation in our lives, which I have endeavored to do likewise with my children. And I would be remiss if I didn't mention another mother, my deceased, remarkable mother-in-law, Mary Barton, a wonderful Christian mother of seven, who in her midlife became hearing impaired, lost her husband, and later her son in a tragic boating accident. But although she lost her hearing and these two very dear people in her life, she did not lose her strength and strong faith in God. She went on to enjoy a productive and independent life and was an inspiration to everyone who met her. Even though life for her was challenging at times, she never asked, "Why me?" and continued to praise God with a song and a smile for all his goodness and blessings towards her. I stand before you today as a bereaved mother with a broken heart. Mother's Day will forever be bittersweet for me. My heart continues to be weighed down by the random, tragic loss of our beautiful daughter, Leah, 3 years ago in Indonesia. She was a shining light and had made such a meaningful and lasting impact on so many lives around the world. Her passing has left a huge hole in the hearts of our family that will never be healed. And when others trying to be sympathetic to our loss say they know how we feel because they have recently lost a close relative too, this sentiment does not compare to the loss of a child. It is unimaginable. I read somewhere that there are three phases of grief: a beginning, a middle, and the rest of your life. Time does pass, but the passage of time only forms a permanent scab over a large wound that will never heal completely. And we who mourn such a personal loss have no choice but to carry on as best as we can, all while continuing to laugh and smile as we meet and greet the outside world, thus becoming very pretentious in public and in dealing with life in general. We therefore become very good actors. John 15, verse Verse 13 tells us there is no greater love than to lay down one's life for another. As a mother who has lost a child, I can personally attest to this passage of scripture. When Leah died, I wished so many times that God had taken my life and spared my daughter's, who at 44 had her whole life and career ahead of her. But this was not to be. And over time, as my emotions became less intense and my anger towards God subsided, I began to realize her sudden passing was all part of his plan. She was on loan for us for 44 wonderful years, and sadly, it was time for her to return to her maker. And although I didn't understand or agree with his plan at the time, I still have faith in God and continue to dwell on his goodness and unconditional love for myself and my family. I know Leah's spirit will always be with me wherever I go and whatever I do, and she would be so proud to see me speaking here today. So this presentation is as much for her as it is for me. I'm also pleased to be the mother of another bright light in my life, my son Jason. And I thank God for his life. Jason, would you mind standing? There's probably many in the congregation. I believe the bond between a mother and her child begins at the moment of conception. She carries an embryo for 9 months, and they are bonded together forever. She will be the primary caregiver of that little person from here on, well into adulthood and even after they have children of their own. It's a total honor and a blessing to be a mom. Motherhood changes your life completely into a fulfilling but challenging experience. No one can ever prepare you for the highs and lows it brings. As a mother, you're engulfed in the rearing of your child 24/7. You wear many hats along the journey, providing an abundance of services, such as that of a nurse in the early years, tending to and soothing scrapes and bruises with band-aids, hugs, and kisses. As chief cook and bottle washer, and back in my day, I did wash and sterilize baby bottles. As a counselor in later years, giving advice on choices and careers in life. As a lawyer, or public defender if criminal circumstances should arise in your child's life. As a financial controller in the home, making sure all the household expenses are paid. And finally, as a lifelong teacher, continually dealing with everything else in life that is thrown your way. All while trying to maintain a healthy, happy home environment for everyone. No sick leave is ever taken, or time off with or without pay. Indeed, you would be a very wealthy mother if you were paid personally for all of these services. But they are all offered freely by you and out of the goodness of your heart. Mothers are survivors and quiet warriors. Being a mother is a difficult role and one of the hardest on earth, and even more so if you're a single mother, attempting to perform the duties of a father as well. It requires a lot of energy, time, commitment, patience, and sacrifice. Life can be so busy and hectic at times, and you become so absorbed in taking care of the needs of the whole family that you seldom have time to look after yourself. You know the drill, last one fed, last one in bed. But still you smile and carry on. You are content in knowing that your child or children are loved unconditionally and cared for both physically and emotionally. They are blessings from God, and you display your thanks to him by endeavoring to be the best mother you can, by catering to their many needs within reason. Children should be taught to love God first, themselves second, and to enjoy love, life to the fullest. Train up a child in the way that it should go, yes, even when they are old, and they will not depart from it. Proverbs 22, verse 6. One of the joys of being a mother is watching your child or children grow and seeing their personality develop into the amazing person they become. A mother wants only the best for her child and is committed to their well-being, continually striving to be the best mother she could possibly be. But in the midst of all the chaos, motherhood can still be full of funny moments that make you smile or even laugh out loud. And why are there no Mother's Day sales? Because mothers are priceless.
Proverbs 31, verse 28 says, her children rise up and call her blessed. If you are fortunate and blessed to still have your mother, give her all the praise and reward she has earned and deserves. Treasure her while she's still here. Take time this Sunday to let her know how much she is loved and what a blessing she is and has been in your life. In closing, the following words are from a poem which has been set and sung to music many times to various artists as a loving tribute to their mother. It's entitled Mother, and no, I'm not going to sing it. M is for the million things she gave me. O means only that she's growing old. T is for the many tears she shed for me. H is for the hands that made a home. E is for everything she's done to help me. And R is for right, and right shall always be. Put them all together and they spell mother, a word that means the world to me. Happy Mother's Day, everybody. God bless you all.
Selection, and I hope that she is listening to this broadcast today. Someone that was very, very important to me in my musical journey, that it totally inspired me when my grandmother had me join the senior choir at age 12. And I was the only one at that time when I started singing. You know, my grandmother was my first choir member, choir director, mother, teacher, father, everything. And when she said that I was going to join the choir, I joined the choir. But this is in honor of Sister Amanda Marshall that inspired me throughout my musical journey to even emulate her. And I hope she's watching. I sing this in her honor. His name is Jesus. That's
made the Lord Jesus the Lord of your life, if you have not received the Lord Jesus as your ancestors, your mother, your grandmother, your auntie, this is the hour. All you have to do is believe in your heart that Jesus is the Son of God, that he died for your sins and mine, and confess with your mouth, you too will become a part of the family of God. Is there one this morning that wants to follow in the footsteps of mom, grandmother? Will you come? His name is Jesus. Will you come to him this morning?
Thank you.